bank of the Great Wolf Lodge, you have a clear view of the Spanish aero car, about 1,500 feet below us. This aerial tram carries sightseers over the mesmerizing waters of the Niagara Whirlpool. The whirlpool's current is so strong that objects can be caught in its swirling waters for weeks before escaping into the lower river. Normally, the whirlpool flows counterclockwise. However, when the river level is low, the whirlpool slows and actually changes direction, an extraordinary natural phenomenon. The lowest water level occurs naturally during the heat of summer. But because the local generating plants divert river water to create hydroelectricity, the water level drops significantly when energy needs are high. This section of the Niagara River, below the falls, is called the Niagara Gorge. It's a favorite destination for hikers, nature lovers, and recreational fishermen. Most scientists believe that 12,000 years ago, the falls were located near Queenston Heights, 11 kilometers downstream from their current location, and actually eroded their way along this stretch of the Niagara River at a rate of about a meter per year. In the early 1950s, when the hydro plants began diverting water, the erosion rate slowed to a mere 3 centimeters per year. When the first European man reported seeing the falls, Father Louis Hennepin, in 1678, the falls would have been close to their current location, but the Canadian Horseshoe Falls would have formed only a shallow U shape. Past the Rainbow Bridge are the American Falls and the narrow Bridal Veil Falls. You'll notice that the river above the American Falls is shallow and turbulent. This is due to naturally occurring massive cracks in the riverbed. Scientists believe that the erosion caused by these powerful rapids will eventually destroy the American Falls. Thankfully, according to their calculations, we still have about 2,000 years to enjoy them just as they are. Experience the magnificence of the falls, you can understand why they've attracted millions of people for centuries. While most visitors are satisfied to gaze at them from shore, some have attempted to challenge their might in daring feats. Although recent daredevil attempts have been fairly successful, we still prefer our more distant, decidedly drier vantage point. The view is simply better up here, and from this angle on a sunny day, you might spot several spectacular rainbows in the mist.
Thank you.
Records inform us that there were more stock held for huge chunks of limestone, showing up plenty of flakes. Some years ago, a daring old canoeer often capitalized on these rapids, but on a spectacular tragedy in a cascade of water, the comforting evidence that this was not such a good idea. We've traveled full circle, and you can once again see the whirlpool at Niagara Heliport. As we prepare for our final descent, you now have a clear view of two massive concrete structures extending down the side of the gorge to the river's edge. These are the hydro-generating plants I spoke of earlier, the Sirac-Bec complex here in Canada, and the Robert Moses complex in the United States. The two large reservoirs on either side of the river hold the water that is brought from the gates upstream until it is needed. For those of you interested in exploring the fascinating process of turning water into electricity, tours are offered at the Sir Adam Beck Generating Complex throughout the day. Before we land, here's some trivia to impress your friends. Niagara Helicopters is the oldest helicopter sightseeing company in the world. You can fly passengers over the falls since 1961. The flags in our parking lot show the countries where the majority of our passengers live. We'll leave it up to you to name them. In all the miles Niagara Helicopters flies in one three-day weekend from place end to end, they would stretch from Niagara Falls to Germany and back. We hope you've enjoyed your flight. For your safety, as we begin our descent into Niagara Heliport, we ask that you please keep your seatbelts fastened until our staff come to help you out. Before you exit the helicopter, please return your headset to where you found it. And as you leave, please walk directly to the exit gates. If you haven't already done so, remember to pick up your free flight certificate in our souvenir shop, where we also have Niagara Helicopters t-shirts, sweatshirts, and pins available. The photograph that was taken as we left is also ready for you in our photo studio. And if flying has given you an appetite, our cafe has a sheltered patio from which you can comfortably view our helicopters outward. Thank you for flying with Niagara Helicopters. Have a wonderful stay in Niagara. We look forward to seeing you again soon. Have a great day and a safe journey home. And remember to check out your takeoff photograph, which is now ready for you in our photo studio.